I'm sorry to have been the bearer of bad news. If there's anything else I can help you with, please ask. Now, can you tell me about these tattoos? Of course. Excuse my hesitation before. She reaches over the guard wire and takes the photo, holds it in her hand. For about half a minute, in silence. Kim says, It was taken with a trigat not long ago. This is the man's upper body. There were no more markings on his hands or legs. Observe the woman's expression. Her mouth is relaxed. The accordion lines near her mouth vanish. The pearls of her eyes move slowly on the photo's surface. What do you think? Sorry, she breaks her concentration. I was trying to see if I can read the web of interdependencies between these points, the stars. She points to the one on the, photo paper. I can't, but that's how you read this story. The points themselves don't have letters, numbers, anything. Their size, location on the body, and distance from each other tells you what they represent. Say nothing. Port cities on the oceans. This is an Aurigny's map of the waterways. A sailor's tattoo, worn by wayfarers of the DeLorean century, as early as 300 years ago. The sailors would mark their bodies to map their travels. What is the use of this map? The sailor's soul would use it to fly back home if they should die abroad. This is a sort of contraption to be reeled back in by. The silver cord, they would call it. What travels did the dead man make? We can tell that. Quite a few. Vredefort, the Aurigny's capital, traditionally stands on the right shoulder. She points to it on the folder. On the photo, sorry. He started somewhere near here, I think. What next? Kim asks. Then he made his way to the Preto Grande, though through what I think must be Stad's Canal, an artificial channel through the Occident. From the Preto, he sailed to the Insulindic Ocean, first to Semenes Islands, then this. She points to his heart. What is that? Revachol, she says. These are the two constants, Vredefort on the shoulder and Revachol in the heart. They started the tradition of these maps right after the discovery of Insulind, at the dawn of the intersolary age. Conceptualization says the old, old world passing by and the new world already here. Kim says, you said you can't read it. I can't. This man was no sailor, and these are no ports. I can understand geographic fragments, but not their meaning. Who could tell me more? His platoon members? The other contractors? Though I do not suggest you go and show them that picture. This man was their friend and comrade. I love the way you're getting money every time. Look at how much money we got. Encyclopedia says, surely there are other people to ask about the tattoo. This is not necessary to complete the task, officer. It's a dangerous side task. Search elsewhere. Okay. Don't ask the platoon members. Well, I don't know who the platoon members, the other contractors. Anyway. Ask Mercs about tattoos. Okay. Well, I got Joyce and Encyclopedia warning me against this, so I'm gonna pass it. You're right, not a good idea. So we can ask other people, I'm guessing, but just don't ask the Mercs. We're supposed to be avoiding the Mercs anyway. You're right, not a good idea. I'm relieved, you think so? I don't think deciphering that tattoo should come before public security. Mind you, of course, we could have accepted it and just not done the quest. Task, mission, whatever. That's all for the tattoos. Thank you for your help. She hands you back the photo. Is there anything else I can help you with? By the way, I've talked to Everard Clare. You have? She smiles carefully. And how did you like Mr. Clare? Physical instrument says, finally, time to choose sides. Well, I'm definitely not saying that. He's a bloated rainbow socialist. Maybe. I can do business with him for socialists. He's reasonable. Maybe. It's not the champion I have chosen. I wish to swear fealty to you. I don't know if I want to swear fealty to either of them. I have the feeling the international community does not approve of him. Oh, come on now. He has his uses. How else would he have stayed in power all these years? Or wait, actually, she answers her own question. Corruption. That's how he's done it. Fantastic, worm-like corruption reaching into the bowels of the earth. That's dramatic. She looks at the ground and nods. Kim says, the position of my unusual colleague does not reflect official policy. I hope you understand. The RCM does not pick sides. Maybe I shouldn't be picking sides. Of course, and I don't expect you to share anything he said he told you with me. I am not a corrupt worm myself. She turns to you. However, if you felt like discussing something, how could I stop you? Are we not human? Are we not curious to hear another person's take? It's only natural. We would only be, she smiles, gossiping. Conceptualization says, intellectually speaking, it would be quite interesting to hear what she has to say about these things. Fine. Yeah, he asked me to deliver an envelope. Sounds like he has you running errands, detective. A well-established dominance ritual, she thinks. Where did he have you deliver it? Here. Here? She looks around. Oh, no. What does that bloated hellbat want with my little cinderblock town? I like it, bloated hellbat. Empathy says, it's clear the village has already grown dear to her. Strangely so. So why did she come here? No, don't tell me. I don't want to know what he has in store for this place. Probably a statue. It's a statue, right? A giant statue of him, or better yet, his twin brother. Practically the same thing, but makes him seem like less like a psychopath. You're quite fond of this little village, aren't you? I should be, she nods. There's that crooked smile again. In my youth, I had a brief dalliance here in Martinese. He was an older man with impossibly broad shoulders. He's probably dead by now. Even his shack is long gone. Not that it matters. These buildings are all carbon copies of one another. You've been to Martinese before? Yes. I was slumming it with some girlfriends of mine. We had boats and... She smiles. Don't hold it against me. My paramour certainly did not. I think we've heard this story. Sounds like you missed those times. Not overly so. It's not like this was the only place we visited. Me and my girlfriends from Ozone, with our shiny boats like reavers. We told ourselves we were the worst thing to happen to the coast since the Coalition landed in 08. Imagine. She tosses her head. So you would prefer something else? Not a youth center? First, there won't be a youth center, whatever he's told you or the residents. It'll be something horrific. Perhaps even worse than a statue. So yes, I do. Like what? A fishery. I've been speaking with Lillian here. She gave me the idea. The infrastructure is all here, and with my connections. Yeah, I was right. I was thinking of a fish factory kind of thing. Sadly, it's just one of the million things I'll never get around to. I just have to accept that I'll never be the rich candy girl who goes around solving people's problems with money. So you're sad you can't buy the place? Yes, I'm sad I will never have the time, Detective. I've always wanted a dilapidating fishing village. Rhetoric says she is more defensive about it than usual. Full of ghosts and ancient memories, she smiles. Has this errant yielded you any information? Well, I already talked about that. Of course, she simmers down. Should something come up later down the road, don't be afraid to drop by for a chat. Is there anything I can help you with? I found my badge, by the way. By love, you did. She inspects the piece of blue plastic, her eyes scanning from left to right. She hands it back to you. Pleased to meet you, Lieutenant W. Freighter Dubois. I am glad to see a man of high qualification. The situation is precarious. Seaweed drips from the badge in your hand. It smells of fish. What can I help you with, Lieutenant Euphrator? I've got some more questions about reality, do I? Oh, these are the things I can retry. We have a better chance for this. Conceptualization. My lessons in basic reality? She's positively surprised. My favorite part of the day. Go ahead, ask me anything. This one's undone. Let's ask about this stuff first. What is this acute encephalopathy? It's a neurological disorder caused by a lack of vitamin B in the brain. Symptoms include retrograde amnesia. It's quite serious. You should get yourself checked out. Empathy says she conveys it in short, cold bursts, trying not to invest too deeply in the condition of this doomed detective. Rhetoric says, in case he goes down later, souring the entire portfolio. What causes encephalopathy? Well, it's either bariatric surgery or long-term alcohol use, then. It's definitely from the drinking, then. She nods slowly. What is this? A bird? She tilts her head. A sphenicid? A flightless bird of the polar regions? Am I really that awkward? Of course you're not, my dear. I'm just terrible at guessing games. I mean, what is this place here? This place is an unmarked micro-settlement on the coast of Martinez. She gestures toward a collection of cinder-block dwellings covered by a highly carcinogenic roofing material. It's lovely, really. I'm thinking of buying it. Really? Yes, so I could spite Everard and spoil his plans for the place. I'm a petty person, I'll admit. Don't worry, I'll never get around to it. The information you pass to me will remain confidential. She waves you off. Let's get back to reality, shall we? What is reach for something fundamental? Conceptualization. And plus 12 for Jamais Vous Thought complete, and plus 2 for Dolores Day. What is all of this? The scent, the sound, the air. What world is this? What world? The fading pearls of her eyes look to the sea. The only one, I suppose, the world of matter, and its pale antipode? Inland Empire says, the camera of her mind glides over the surface of the water. What do you see? Great bodies of water, forest-covered surfaces, clusters of light where the cities lie. You've seen the montage. We all have. This world is enough, she concludes. There's a term of endearment they coined for it. In the DeLorean century, when humanity was high on this world, discovering more and more of it, these archipelagos included. What is it? Elysium. Wait, is this the one with the evil apes? Not in this case, no. That sounds more like something the Mesk petrofascists might say. Her gaze wanders. Encyclopedia says, the Confederate Republic of Mesk, the world's largest state by territory, has fallen into an especially nihilistic strain of nationalism lately. Her eyes return to you. It isn't enough to call us animals. Even animals aren't animals. What are animals, then? They're like you and I suppose. Living organisms? Don't identify with abstractions. Elysium is for particular beings. Elysium. The world needs a term of endearment. It does. There are those who would call it a hell. What is hell? A term of hatred that originates, like many such things, with the Mesk petrofascists. I don't feel like I've gotten the whole picture yet. Oh, you want a picture of the world. She raises her finger to her lips. There is no complete set yet, dear. They're having some trouble reaching orbit. How come? Great things are difficult to achieve. For now, we're viewing the world from the inside. Sideways. Inside sideways. What shape is this world, then? We used to think it was a sphere, but that is beginning to look less and less likely by the day. You wouldn't know it from the tabloids, but the ORG nations have been launching weather balloons into the lower ionosphere since the 30s. Encyclopedia says it stands for Occident Revachol Grad. We're getting rich off this thought. I love this. Joyce says, there's a steadily increasing trickle of images. Between the three scientific contributors, they're piecing together a dark gray corona. A dark gray corona? Yes, she pauses. Pale covers 72% of the surface. There are gray flares and prominences, even arcs above entire isolas. The images are blurry, but if there was a sphere in there, it certainly looks like it fractured a long time ago. Half-Life says that a cold fear seeps into you. Oh my god, wait, what the hell are you telling me? You seem to be spooked. Please don't be. Her voice becomes homely, calm. She lets a moment pass. Homely. The Pale? And what do you mean, Corona? They say there is a rarefied envelope of matter surrounding the darkened disk of our planet. That is, if we're still living on a planet. Or, to speak more plainly, imagine vast swaths of land disrupted by nothingness. A rarefied envelope of matter. The disk of our planet. I am sorry, dear, she looks around. It must sound quite terrifying through the acute encephalopathy. Even scientific positivism isn't entirely convinced about what we're dealing with here. But this is one of the great questions of our time. Maybe when they get the complete set together, it will jolt us out of our rut, bring us together, however naive it may sound. A fractured Corona doesn't feel like it's going to bring anyone together. You have misimagined it. I don't have the power to convey to you the effect and geometry of the images that depict our world from below low orbit. It's... She looks up. It's like the crowning of the world. It's insane. Very disco. You'd love it. Doesn't sound like any kind of disco I'd like to go to. But you already have, she looks around, and you're doing just fine, despite the rubble. Inland Empire says, suddenly you're conscious of yourself standing there on whatever this all is. Your arms hang down by your sides. The lieutenant observes you both, silently. He adjusts his glasses. You said pale. What is pale? The pale is not, technically speaking, part of reality. Yes, the lieutenant looks at his watch. Also, I think we've had enough excitement for today. We do have a case to attend to. Yeah, I know, but I'm really curious about the pale. I just read a book yesterday evening about the medicinal workings of the veil, or the pale. Not the veil. Medicinal, I forget what it's called. That we can go into, like, meditation and reach the pale, or go to the pale and meditate there, or something like that, to heal ourselves. Authority says, Kim's voice is low, but firm. All she can say is, Of course, Lieutenant. She bows, then turns to you. Let's try something else. What do you mean it's not part of reality? Ma'am, he turns to her again, remember, you're dealing with a very sensitive and impressionable police officer who is still recovering from a recent medical episode. Damn it, Kim, I want to know. Talk to Joyce about the pale without Kim. Ah, we should talk to her before. Kim was gone all day yesterday. Lieutenant's right. Let's change topics. Gives you a little wink. What do you want to know? Anything. Savoir Faire says you could sneak back later when the lieutenant is not here. Unless you can convince him to step aside. Yeah, we have a good chance of doing that. Alright, but let's try this first. What is... Think of something close. Didn't I just do this? Plus one for RCM can access ICP database. Plus one for authority comes from coalition. Plus one for decomptage known. Plus one Kim debrief done. Oh, fail! Huh. It remains a mystery what you mean by this something close. This isn't about you, it's about reality. Alright, ask for Kim to step away while you discuss the pale. Oh, fail! Really? We're doing horrible right now. Volition says, is what you want to do, but should you? He expressly stated you shouldn't hear about it. What if it renders you mad, or catatonic, or it makes you lose your memory again? Yes? She's waiting for another... term. That's all for now. Glad to have been of assistance, the little that I know. Anything else? We've been talking to her for quite a while. Talk to Joyce about the kale. The pale. I'm talking about kale. I hate kale. Damn it. Without Kim. Yeah, Lieutenant Katsuragi does not want you to hear about something called the pale. Probably think it will prove traumatic. Return to Joyce once he is not there and ask her about it. Or get him to step away for a second. We failed on that. So we'll do that. Yeah, absolutely. We can do it when we come back to rest, because it looks like we're here. Friday, nothing. Okay, I got 2 skill points. What I want to do is open up another thought cabinet, because I don't want to get rid of Monty Dom. That's awesome. I don't like the suggestion thing, but Encyclopedia, every time it... Encyclopedia is always chiming in. And every time I get 10 XP and 2 real, we're getting rich here. So, means you can buy more books and stuff. You can buy those fallen pants from Kuno. I want to do all the things, or at least as many things as possible. Unlock. And then here... 20 hours, wow. I want to try something that's quick. I want to try to pare some of this stuff down. See what might be worth something. This is the shortest one. For opioid receptor antagonist. Oh, should we take this? You can see it so clearly. In a dark alley behind a boite de nuit, a young couple is having sex on a shopping cart. Their eyes are bloodshot and their brains fried. They're in the throes of narcomania. On the top floor of an office building, a young exec takes a drag from a short spliff and his eyes roll to the back of his skull. He, too, is a narcomaniac. Someone needs to take a stand. The world needs a narc. The world needs you. Don't worry, you can still drink and smoke. Those aren't real drugs. If I don't like it, I'll just forget it. I mean, are we gonna have to go around arresting everybody? I'll see if it gives me anything useful, and then we can just forget it and go on to something else. It'll be over quick enough anyway. If it was something like 6 hours or 20 hours, I wouldn't bother. We want to try to forge that signature.
Aye, the sea's gonna calm down soon, I can feel it. The wind is turning southeast. What's on your mind, officer?
Thought I'd talk to her about the washerwoman refusing, but no. Ruby left the village and went up the coast. Explorer for signs. While I'm here, might as well just look for signs everywhere. Looking for clues. What about this here? A door. A building. A hiding place. Could the instigator be inside? There's no way the perp is in here, officer, physical instrument says. Look how scarred the boards are. All attempts to pry them off have failed. Can I try to get in, though? Not this time. The opposition is insurmountable. But I like the spirit. Have some points. It's lonely and cold without points. And dangerous, Inland Empire says. Dangerous, too. Kim, do you think she's in there? The suspect? God, I hope not. I can't see a way in. He inspects the bars, though many have tried. Nothing more to do here, then. That's where the people were... Not arrested. They were executed, people there. Should I look at this again? I don't know why. I just feel like I should look at this again. We're lucky it's still here. A little longer and it would have floated away. It's empty, though. The lieutenant flashes a mirthless half-smile. We still got here too late. There's nothing of use here anymore. Indeed. Can't go that way. Take a look at this again. You see a once bright mural towering above you. The signage has peeled off over the years, but you can still make out Feld Electrical R&D. Task updated. Above the mural, a collapsed roof, broken windows set in walls that are cracking and will soon also fall, and the coastal breeze rustling and sighing in the remains of the edifice. Conceptualization says, Feld Electrical. How ironic, all these dark rooms. Encyclopedia says, Feld Electrical. You only know them as a small company that makes ink cartridges. Looks like they used to be big. There's something in the wind, Inland Empire says. Sometimes the only way to go forward is to fail first. Could Ruby be in there? In there? Kim says. She could, or, he points behind you, she could be in the identical ruin over there, or in that boat shack, or in that church tower, maybe. Logic says, why single out this one building? Listen to the wind. Shivers. Plus +3 for found the empty trap and heard Lena's true story. Plus +1 for reconstructed execution and found the jacket. Probably gonna fail on it, of course. Yeah. Suddenly, it's quiet. There is no cold hand brushing against your forehead. No rustle in the reeds. The wind has died down or gone behind a corner. You only hear distant waves washing the coast. She could be anywhere. How do we find her? How do we? I was really hoping she'd be in the village. The lieutenant sighs and gets a hold of himself. Okay. She's probably north of the village, and this place is a peninsula. He looks north. We already scanned most of the outdoor areas on our wild cryptid hunt, so we have an understanding of the geography, at least. And then there's the church. He looks at the bell tower. We've already searched that and can rule it out. I know it doesn't feel like progress, but exclusion is a step, too. It's true. Anyway, we do it the old-fashioned way, sector by sector. Go over the whole peninsula, ask the locals, enter the places where we can enter first, like we did in the village. What was I even attempting to do here? Shivers says, trying to talk to the wind, the city? Whatever you thought would happen did not, and now you're just standing there, in the pale of the morning, with your hands fallen to your side. Logic says, is trying to talk to the city something you've done before? Is it... in your secret repertoire? A trick for when you're out of ideas? Alright, Kim, so if that fails, if we don't find her? Then, if we're desperate, we can look where we can't enter. Bunkers, storm drainage, this place. I'm sure it won't come to that. He looks behind him at the dark red box crumbling across the chasm. Shiver says, walk the coast, the Ord Boardwalk, the reeds. You can always come back here and talk to the wind again. Look where it already got you. Savoir Faire says, an adventure awaits, an adventure on the windswept urban coast. Endurance says, buckle up and raise your collar. This search is going to be wet and cold. Yep. Return to the Feld mural and consult the wind if you don't know what to do. Other than that, keep searching the coast. Interesting. Well, we'll be doing that next episode, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.